Right, Jenny, you ain't totally gave up. You trying to figure out how you gonna fix it. See, we be figuring it out. And we say, well, God, I'm going to do it this way. And God just sitting there saying, when you going to leave it alone? And then when we just get frustrated, say, God, I can't do it no more. Work it out. Then all of a sudden, God comes in. He comes in and he places everything in a place it should be. Then all of a sudden, the things start working out. Peace comes. Hope comes. Joy comes. Financial comes. Life comes. Peace comes. Love comes. Then all of a sudden, you're walking and laying in the back on the floor shouting. I don't know what was going on, but I know he worked it out. He had done something for that woman because he worked it out. But when God is in control of our situations and our life, we can be assured that it's going to turn out all right. Make no difference in the sickness. Make no difference what it is. If we learn to give it to God, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and his righteousness. Trust a sweeter frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name, on Christ, the solid rock I stand. On other grounds is sinking sand. Come on, somebody say, hold on. Hold on to his everlasting arm. Hold on to his peace. Hold on to his joy. Hold on to his love. Hold on to his patience. Haven, you're going to lift up and say, what the last of that scripture say? It say you're going to praise him in the congregation. You're going to praise him. Listen to this, Catherine. You're going to praise him in the congregation. You're going to praise him in front of the elders. Come on, somebody. You didn't finish the chapter. You didn't run the race. You didn't done what you had to do. You didn't gave it to God.
Let go and let God. Then you can say, but God.
it wasn't me. He was. When she posted up, when she get her new house, and all of this picked up, y'all over there for ribs and stuff, call me. Because I love you, I will travel 8 hours. Ruben said, you drove all the way 8 hours just to get some rest. I will come to the cabin, come on, sit down in your new house. But God, gonna do it. He's gonna prove to the naysayers around you. The naysayers that you ain't gonna name or that they ain't gonna. But when God put his hand in this government mess, it is a mess anyway. But when God put his hand, all the rules changes. He changes every the hearts of the king is in the master's hand. And they started to march at his beat. They don't know why they're giving this woman this. I don't know why they're giving this woman 60,000. But God, their hand is moving, and they're looking, they're going, and they're probably what's happening. Because God is in control. They're going in their wallet, they're writing up contracts. They're giving out people homes and blessing with cars and giving them everything. They don't understand that God is in control.
Your Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Glory to God.